Point north, east, west, and south.
Cloudy in the west.
Headline is the NZBC News.
Good evening, citizens.
Can you give it a tweet?
Coming up on tonight's broadcast, the disturbing phenomenon that threatens to decimate our best-loved celebrities.
Stand the fuck down!
Inside Iraq, the documentary that shocked America.
I challenge the president to do my rotation.
And more inappropriate titillation in the EML sealed section.
Is blazen, is geen ballon.
Good evening. Tonight, we discuss a problem so shocking, it threatens to destroy the very fabric of our society from the inside of that very fabric. It's a disturbing new phenomenon that experts say affects up to 2 in 3 adults. Your sister or brother could be a sufferer, your girlfriend or boyfriend, perhaps even your mother. No, it's not pee. It's something far worse. And the sad thing is, we've only got ourselves to blame.
Well, the first time that it happened, I was putting out the rubbish. And I felt myself being forced to the ground. My clothes were ripped off. I felt overpowered. It all happened very fast. It took me a while to understand what had happened, and for a long time, I didn't want to admit it. But then it happened a second time. And by the third time, I had to confront the fact that I had actually raped myself.
29-year-old Gary Ridge has a serious problem.
Eventually, it got to the point where I found myself loitering outside my own house, lying in wait, sort of. You know, that's when I realised that it had become something quite serious. Eventually, I realised that I was turning on myself, somehow. It was like I was turning myself on and then turning on myself, sort of.
Rape. It could well be the most disturbing four-letter word in the English language. But what happens when you place a more innocent word in front of it? A word like self. Suddenly you've given a name to the most disturbing psychosexual disorder this country has ever seen. Self-rape occurs when an individual's natural sexual instincts combine with dangerously low self-esteem. The self-rapist attacks himself, usually without his own knowledge, hijacking the body's own sex drives and turning them on itself in a kind of autoerotic own goal.
I know this sounds wrong, but sometimes I find myself looking at myself in the mirror, you know, when I'm getting ready to go out or something, and I think, God, you're really asking for it in that outfit. In a way, giving a name to it has been a big help. For years, I just thought I was a terrible wanker. You know, I felt guilty. But to know that I actually have a proper disorder, yeah, that's definitely been a relief.
Self-rape is not just a 21st century phenomenon. History is littered with secret self-abusers. George Orwell, Albert Einstein, and our own Ernest Rutherford, who is said to have suffered acutely from what the Nobel Prize winner memorably described as a diabolical discourtesy. These days, one of the biggest problems for self-rape victims is getting the police and other authorities to take them seriously. So you went to the cops. What happened?
I said to the cop, I think I've just been raped. And he asked me to describe the offender. And when I said, well, I think I've raped myself, he just fell about laughing. You've got no idea how that feels.
A lot of people watching this would say that self-rape is just masturbation.
You try telling that to someone who's just tied themselves up and violated themselves with their own Sky remote.
Distraught at a lack of understanding within the community, Gary established his own support group for self-rapists and their victims.
Hello, Self-Rape Crisis, Gary speaking.
And now, a television campaign is in the making.
Okay, standing by and roll!
Piha Beach on Auckland's west coast, and a film crew is busy shooting an ad for Self-Rape Awareness Week.
Cut it there. Okay, that's good.
Acclaimed actor Joel Tobik has agreed to be the face of self-rape.
As an actor, you often get called a wanker. I suppose that's just a joke. But I've seen how damaging self-rape can be when it goes unchecked. And it's no joke. An actor friend of mine once self-raped during a performance of King Lear. The audience thought it was part of the show.
Yeah, we're very happy with Joel.
Yeah.
We think he's going to be a great fit for us, especially since the Mad Butcher fell over. We found Joel through an agency called Starfight, which attaches celebrities to disorders. They found us Joel, and they're currently working on getting us on Dancing with the Stars as a chosen charity.
So before you call someone a wanker, think again.
Increased awareness has brought self-rape to the attention of the Sensible Sentencing Trust. They worry that self-rapists could be getting off scot-free.
Look, our main concern is the obvious risk that one of these self-rapists are going to graduate and become a full-blown rapist. I mean, we need to act preemptively. Government needs to act. These people need to be locked away.
But there are some who say the solution to the self-rape problem is much simpler. Why? Because they say the problem doesn't actually exist.
The whole thing was invented by Big Pharmaceutical. They're basically telling chronic wankers there's something wrong with them.
Claude Logan has waged a lifelong battle with autoerotic urges, but refuses the term self-rapist.
They invented that term, those companies. The conceit is that they give something a new name, call it a disorder, and you know, there's this whole new market. It's that they've created the problem to sell the cure. As if we didn't feel guilty enough for wanking, you know, now we're being told there's something wrong with us and only expensive medicines can help us.
That medicine, xenotocin.
We've all got a name for it.
Bashing the boomerang.
Joking the chicken.
Spanking the monkey.
Jacking the beanstalk.
Tweaking the map of Tasmania.
It may sound funny, but self-abuse is a dangerously debilitating disorder. Xenotocin is the only safe and approved treatment for chronic self-abuse. Xenotocin, the drug you can trust when you can't trust yourself.
Logan used xenotocin in desperation, but found there were side effects.
It made me impotent, basically. And yet it also increased my libido, so I had these terrible urges, yet I couldn't act upon them, so, and I lost my sense of taste.
Logan says his wanking is now under control, thanks mainly to herbal remedies and traditional Māori medicine, taken orally as a de-stimulant. Tariana Turia's korero has proved particularly effective.
We're not focused on race or skin colour. We're focused on wakapapa, genealogy and justice. Those are the things.
At $160 a bottle, few sufferers can afford xenotocin. Most have to resort to cruder measures. And until understanding in the wider community improves, Gary, Claude, and others like them seem destined to go on fearing the one person they can never escape. If you think someone close to you suffers from self-rape, remember the worst thing you can do is to tell them to harden up. Still to come, inside this week's sealed section, forget a gender or waka huia, this is what they call charter television in the Netherlands. It's a detailed how-to guide of how's your father, tell Nana it's time for bed, and kids ask your parents or caregiver. And the remarkable film from war photographer Sean Smith.
I challenge anybody in Congress to do my rotation.